There's some people that get a flash in the pan of success, yeah. and then there's some people that have success for decades. What you're training people on right now, Dennis, is to learn how to operate a company.
Let's go.
Hey guys, what's going on? All right, so this video is gonna be about securing the sell today and forever, okay? So I'm gonna hand it over to Dennis. Dennis, walk us through on how to become the biggest and the baddest.
Yeah, this is really the second pillar of a great F&I manager. A F&I manager that's just totally focused on securing the sale in the moment so we can have many more sales in the future. So when I'm talking about securing the sale now, I want you to think about this as F&I managers, we are oftentimes the last substantive point of contact a customer has before they leave the dealership. It's our job to put a bow on that deal. We want that customer feeling like they made the right decision dealing with not only the salesperson, right? So if Andy's my salesperson and he's done a great job with that customer as an F&I manager, I wanna make sure Andy knows and that customer knows that Andy is the best and the baddest and they made a great decision choosing to do business with Andy, and also making sure that customer knows that they made a great decision doing business with our dealership. We wanna just shower them with love, because when we're the last point of contact, we can either destroy that deal right then and there, or at minimum destroy it for in the future. So really taking care and securing that sale now has to do with CSI. It also has to do with making sure that paperwork is nailed, right? Last thing a salesperson wants to do is come back in and they lose a car deal because Dennis, their F&I manager, didn't do their paperwork right. So securing the sales, paperwork, and CSI.
Yeah, so I was gonna say, this is big. So CSI clearly is massive, right? I mean, it can affect your allocation. I mean, everything you get, right? How you get paid, if you have it tied to your pay plan.
Yep.
I mean, literally a salesman could do everything right, but his finance guy cannot do it right and he doesn't get paid. Now I need you to understand something. When you said this is the last point of contact, I think when something's done twice or three times, it shows that it's real, right? Mm-hmm. So if the salesman's done a good job and the F&I guy does a really good job, then it's just validation that this is a great company. Yep. Hey guys, what's going on? It's Andy. A lot of you leave comments telling me that you need help. Do me a favor. I'm going to tell you the best way to get a hold of me. Shoot me a text message right now, 918-210-0254. 918-210-0254. I'll help you with whatever you need. I got your back for life. Let's get back to the video, right? But how many times does one or the other do a good job, but the other one doesn't? You know what I'm saying? And both of them. So this gives you an opportunity, even if the salesman messes up, okay, to be the last thing that they think about. You know, during a close, all somebody remembers is the last 30 seconds in a negotiation, okay? Yep. So even if I messed up the first 4 minutes, as long as my last 30 seconds strong, you might still go ahead and do it, okay?
Yep.
It can't start out strong and then end weak.
Yep.
But it could start out weak and end strong and still close out.
Yep.
So what he's saying is that you're the closer. You're the total closeout of how they felt about the company, how they walk away, signatures that count, right? I mean, I know front-end paperwork signatures count, but I mean, the real signatures count in the F&I office, okay? So I just wanted to say, like you're the end-all, be-all, man.
Yeah.
Like you're so much more than what you're playing it as you are.
Yeah.
And we just want you to know that so you can be like, dude, man, like this is big. And then when you get that and you get to play this part, then next thing you know, when you're running your store or you're the GM in the future or because you became great, you'll know what to expect from your people, right?
Yep.
Like to me, that's the biggest deal, is that why I wanna learn this, Dennis, is because I wanna know how to be deadly at this. So as I go to my next level, that I make sure that the people that work for me, they're deadly at it too, because I was great at it when I did it.
Yeah, you make such a great point, right? There are people that will buy a car even though the experience from the get-go wasn't great because either they got a good deal, they're just tired of shopping, whatever the case may be. So as an F&I manager, is that last point of contact, you can put that train back on the tracks for the dealership. You know, this customer might share something with you that's a real problem. You can share that feedback with the sales manager, with the general manager, maybe you got a CSI agent, and we can take steps to salvage that relationship so the customer leaves the dealership feeling, hey, at least they got somebody that cares about me and my family and make sure everything's good. So, and that really bleeds into the future, right? You've got to take care of these customers everything you do for them has got to be in their best interest. You want to look out for them. And when I say being in their best interest, sharing all your F&I products, everything you have available on the menu, and letting them make the decision whether or not they're going to buy it, and properly disclosing it and making them feel good about the entire transaction is key. And when we do that at a very high level, we're preparing for our future, because I really believe the F&I office is the foundation of the repeat and referral business. Mm. There's all these different products, right, Andy?
Yeah.
You got service contracts, maintenance plans, tire and wheel, key, the list goes on and on. But think about it, if I do a great job offering those up to you, you think they're a great benefit for you and your family. Next thing you know, 6 months down the road, year down the road, you're coming back in for your maintenance, your car brakes, you're sitting down with your service advisor, and you're just handing them the service advisor the key, and like, bro, no problem. Everything's taken care of for you. You're not going to have a bill, right? They feel good. That customer feels good.
And they're
forever for life. So when you're taking care of these customers, F&I managers, man, treat them like the gold they are. Like, that customer is the last one you're ever going to get, and make sure everything's clean, tight, disclosed, and they want to come back, and partner with that sales department to make sure you got a great experience for you, your dealership, and your salespeople.
Yeah, and I think just to finish on that, do you have anything else you want to say on this? Well, something I wanted to say is this. See farther than the hand in front of your face. Just see farther than the hand in front of your face. So right now, Dennis, I'm in the F&I office. I see a paycheck. That's what I see. We know what people see.
Yeah.
I see a paycheck, okay? And as I'm looking at that paycheck, all I'm looking is dollars and cents.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna ask a question. How old are you right now? Are you 38 years old? Are you 48 years old? Are you 25 years old? Right, like what does your future look like? Like, understand this. If you don't get great at F&I, you will never grow past being a salesman in a dealership.
Amen.
You might even go to the desk and graduate there, but you'll be demoted back to the floor. There's some people that get a flash in the pan of success, and then there's some people that have success for decades. What you're training people on right now, Dennis, is to learn how to operate a company.
Yeah.
And to understand how money flows, and understand how business works, and to understand their business.
Yeah.
That this, the cost to acquire a new customer is very expensive.
Yeah.
But if we do these things right, we're guaranteeing insured that in the next 18 to 24 months to 36 months, that that client will come back and buy, plus their family, kids, wife, they'll buy, and their friends will buy.
Yeah, 100%.
So, and it doesn't acquire more money. All it acquires is for us to be professionals.
Absolutely.
So I just wanted to say that, because I feel like as you're making these points, like, a lot of people say, well, I know this. I know, but you don't do it.
Yeah.
Okay, what you know to do and what you do are two separate things. You know, if you wake up in the morning and go to the gym, you'll be in shape, but you still haven't gone. Okay, I just want to say that, like this is something that we take very serious. So as he's saying it, I'm saying, don't take it lightly. This is operating a business 101.
Well, and that forward-looking finance manager you're talking about that really takes this very serious, because there's finance managers. I know of finance managers that get into the seven-figure income category because they're great at what they do. And they're always looking to the future. And if you think about it, if you're doing a great job selling all these F&I products, the customer comes back and has that great experience in the service department, which they deserve. They don't want to be in the service department, but they go in and have a great experience anyway. And then they happen to bump in Andy, the greatest salesman in the world. He's got somebody to talk to, and they're so enamored with the great job the finance manager did with them last time. They're like, that same package I had last, just hook it up the same way. And then you're in and out with that deal and on to the next in seconds.
Yeah, and we'll finish with this. I love what Dennis said in the beginning, if you caught it. I always listen to everything everybody says. He said pillar. A pillar is something that holds something up. The pillar for every dealership in the world, yes, people would say it is sales, right? No, it's not, because you can't stay in business if you don't handle this part right. Am I right?
Absolutely.
You can sell as much as you. I know a lot of people that sold a lot that went out of business because they couldn't figure this out, okay? So I just want to say this. This is going to make you powerful. This is going to bring your value up. This is going to make you be an expert. This is going to make you be a pro. So some of these videos go a little longer. Some of them are shorter. But everything that we talk about is 100% of a necessity. And if you learn this as the pillar of your foundation, of the way that you do business, well, number one, your future looks very bright.
Yeah.
And number two, when people work for you in the future, you'll know how to train them, which is what we're doing now. We're training the trainer. wake up to a little bit of drool on my pillow, feel like it's gonna be. Hey guys, I just want to tell you, you're the true one percenters. You made it till the end of the video. Do me a favor, share it with a friend that wants to go to another level. Make sure you like the video, comment below so I know who you are. Set your notifications and then subscribe to the channel. We got daily sales training videos dropping. I'll see you soon. I'm about to quit my job, cash in for a ticket. I'm going on a trip and I don't plan to visit. I'm gonna